अगर फॉरेन जाना लाइफ के लिए इतना इम्पोर्टेंट है तो पौष्टिक आहार, क्लीन एनवायरनमेंट लाइफ के लिए तो पक्का इम्पोर्टेंट है ना। नमस्कार, वेलकम टू इम्पोर्टेंट सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजमेंट सीरीज एपिसोड 3। In this video, we are going to discuss one of the important fundamental right without which our existence itself will be compromised. Yes, I am talking about right to life and personal liberty provided by Article 21. Today's discussion will be dedicated to a landmark judgment of Supreme Court which reinforced our right to life, and the case is Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India 1978. We will not only discuss the judgment but also the factors that led to the judgment and its profound impact on the citizens. Before jumping directly to the judgment, we should first understand what is this right to life and personal liberty. It is very interesting. Listen very, very carefully. Article 21 says, "No person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to procedure established by law." I am repeating again, no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to procedure established by law. Means if a law is passed following a proper procedure, it can take away liberty of an individual. Which also means if ever your right to life is violated and you appeal in Supreme Court won't see whether the law is good or bad. It will only see Parliament followed proper procedure or not while passing that law. If proper procedure is followed, court won't declare it void even if the law will be arbitrary, even if the law will be oppressive. Article 21 indirectly said court can only examine the procedure but cannot question the law. You don't feel good after listening all this? That is why we are going to study Menaka Gandhi case so that we feel relieved. The whole drama started from a simple question. Whether right to travel abroad comes under personal liberty or not? This simple question, and we will try to answer this simple but interesting question with the help of two stories. And remember, both of these stories are connected to each other. Story number one. There was a businessman named Satwant Singh whose business was importing and exporting automobile parts. Obviously, this kind of profession needs regular foreign travel. One day, while Satwant Singh was about to travel abroad, External Affairs Ministry instructed him to submit his passport. Why? Because there was a pending case against him and he was suspected of leaving India to avoid the trial. He filed a petition. The case name is Satwant Singh versus Assistant Passport Officer 1967. He said, "My personal liberty is violated. If I am unable to travel according to my need, what kind of liberty I have?" But as I told you before, country can take away your liberty only when there is a procedure established. But Indian Passport Act 1920 was having no procedure for surrendering the passport. Hence, Supreme Court cancelled the order given by External Affairs Ministry. Immediately, Parliament passed Passport Act 1967, and how passport can be issued, refused, revoked, impounded, all these provisions were inserted there. Story number two. In last video, we studied how Mrs. Indira Gandhi imposed emergency in 1975. Many political leaders were jailed, fundamental rights were restricted, media was censored. People were obviously not happy with all this oppressive behavior, and image of Congress party suffered a lot. Hence, in 1977, Janata Party came to power and Mr. Morarji Desai became Prime Minister of India. Meanwhile, Mrs. Menaka Gandhi, who was daughter-in-law of Indira Gandhi, was running a political magazine. Its name was Surya. She used Surya magazine to restore image of Congress party again. Not just that, Surya magazine also defamed leaders of Janata Party. In 1977, when she wanted to go abroad, she received a letter from Government of India saying her passport is impounded, means seized. When she asked the reason, she got a reply that reason cannot be disclosed because it is not in the interest of general public. One, you confiscated my passport, and second, you are not even giving proper reason. She filed a petition, thus the case name is Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India 1978. Government told, "Dear Supreme Court, last time you let Satwant go because we had no proper procedure, but now time is different. We have elaborate procedure to confiscate passports in Passport Act 1967. Supreme Court told, I understand you have a procedure, but the procedure established by law under Article 21 has to be fair, just, reasonable and cannot be oppressive and arbitrary. Hence, court upheld the previous judgment and said right to go abroad is equal to right to personal liberty. Just look at the two stories. In both the stories, government put restriction on traveling abroad. But in story 1, court objected because there was no procedure. In second story, court objected even if there is a procedure. Because according to Supreme Court, arbitrary procedure is not a valid procedure. Now it is time to learn two political jargons. When court focuses only on procedure of the law, it is called a procedure established by law. But when court also focuses whether the law is good or bad, it is called due process of law. American Constitution follows due process of law. There, court not only focuses on the procedure but also analyzes whether a law is good for citizens or not. Until Menaka Gandhi case, India followed procedure established by law, but after this case, Supreme Court recognized due process of law. Hence, now Article 21 can be newly interpreted as no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except fair, just and reasonable procedure established by law. Imagine, if I am unable to go abroad, what kind of life I have? If this kind of question can be asked by a citizen, then definitely another citizen will ask, if I don't get food, what kind of life I have? If my surrounding environment is not clean, what kind of life I have? Agar foreign jana life ke liye itna important hai, to paushtik ahar, clean environment, life ke liye to pakka important hai na? Hence, after Menaka Gandhi case, right to life was no more confined to right to go abroad, rather the concept was expanded to a lot of important aspects of life. Example, right to livelihood, right to shelter, right to health, right to privacy, right to information, right to free education up to 14 years of age, right to decent environment including pollution-free water and air, all were included under Article 21, right to life. Even right to sleep, right to road in hilly areas, right to family pension, right to appropriate life insurance policy comes under right to life and personal liberty. And not just you and me, even a culprit who has committed a crime against society enjoy Article 21 because all the following provisions fall under right to life. What are they? Right against handcuffing, right against solitary confinement, right of prisoner to have necessities of life, right against custodial harassment, right to fair trial, right of appeal from a judgment of conviction, right against public hanging. All these come under right to life and personal liberty. Whenever these rights get violated, Human Rights Commission take help of Article 21 to protect the victims. Thus, an interpretation which started with right to abroad so wonderfully became a repository of so many human rights. What do you think? Is there something else in our society which should be included under right to life? Please be a participative student and drop your comment what else should be included under Article 21. I hope the video was insightful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Umkar signing out. Till we meet next time. Bye bye.